Song is from a new record that I'm going to be putting out on August the 18th. I'm really excited about it. Over the last couple of years, I kind of fell out of love with this whole being in a band thing. I really got myself burned out in a way that I've never done before, and started questioning whether or not I wanted to even do this or how I wanted to do this. And so before I went completely insane, I decided that what I was going to do was I was going to turn the band loose, which I did, and then I was going to just put myself out on the road with a couple of guitars and ride around in my truck and do this sort of old-fashioned and see if songs came out of it and see if I still enjoy doing this or not. And I did, which was great for me. I don't say that fishing for your applause, but I appreciate it. but it sort of did, it rekindled my love for this and why I wanted to do it. I think when you do this long enough, you eventually, and you have to sort of forget why you started this in the first place, and then you go back and try to remember that again. And stripping everything back and kind of going back to this format has helped me do that. And another thing that helped was my kids started a band. Yeah. My kids are 9 and 6. They were 8 and 5 when they started their band. It was really life-changing. And I mean that in a good way. I watched them. There's 3 of them. It's my boys and another neighborhood kid. Neighborhood kid plays drums. My oldest boy plays lead guitar. And my youngest boy is the lead singer. And they're called The Lonely Man. They have 3 songs at this point. One of which is called Into Darkness. It's everything you want out of a song. The other one is called George, You Are Under Arrest. Written and sung by my youngest son, George. I hope it is not foreshadowing. But I realized as I was watching them rehearse in my garage, because they don't know anything about music. They can't play at all. And I mean, like my oldest boy, I mean, we can tune it all to sort of one open note and he can sort of thumb his way through shit. But they're terrible. And it is so much fun because they are having a ball. And I don't say they're terrible making fun. Like, it's exactly what you should be at 6 and 9 years old. You should just be out there trying to figure it out. And the other neighborhood kids stop by and headbang and dance. And I watch them get excited about the fact that people stop by the garage to see them play. And I realize that's where all of this started. Somewhere along the line, you know, you do this long enough and it's easy to get sidetracked into record sales or ticket sales and things that, I mean, ultimately, they matter on a certain level, but it's not why you ever wanted to start doing this in the first place. And watching them really got me thinking back to when I first got a guitar and it was just trying to learn to play songs and sing songs to probably, like all good singer-songwriters, just to impress a girl. And, so that's this is the story of that. Innocence. This is a called 17. Daddy's in the kitchen, ain't got much to say. Mama's gone to church, cause all she ever does is pray. I'm up here with this guitar, just trying to learn to play. My way. Just look my way. make that left hand turn on the Belmont Boulevard. Cigarettes and cheap black shades like some 70s rock and roll star. Only thing I'll ever want is everything you are.
Never gonna change when you're 17.